Good morning, everyone. Happy Wednesday. So glad you could be here. This is a surprise pop-up stream. I had a little bit of free time in my schedule this morning, didn't have anything else to do, and I thought to myself, wow, I could go for a little bit of wrestling, R-A-S-S-L-I-N, and figured, why not hop on stream? Hey, good to see you, Stock for Water. I am so seldom on in the mornings. Usually either I'm at work or I'm here with my daughter, and it's, you know, sort of time focused on that sort of thing. So this is a rare Wednesday morning. Glad to see you. That's right, brother. Decaf Man Jedi Mania is running wild. Good to see you, Chrono Travis. Welcome, man. I'm super excited this morning. So glad you could be here. This is actually going to be the first of two streams today. I'm going to be doing Day of the Tentacle tonight for Retro Adventure Wednesday. That'll be around 9:30 p.m. Eastern. I'm super hyped for Day of the Tentacle. I haven't played it literally, I think, basically since it came out. I loved it then, but really haven't touched it since. So I'm really looking forward to revisiting Day of the Tentacle. But this morning, the business at hand is going to be SmackDown versus Raw 2007 for the PlayStation 2. Y'all know I love a good wrestling game. And in this case, what I'm really excited about for this one, as the stream title says right down there somewhere, this game has what is purported to be a pretty bonkers story mode. It's supposed to be a really good story mode. Lots of actual voice acting, some pretty complex storylines, a lot of branching paths and stuff like that. But apparently it also goes into some pretty bizarre places. So I'm looking forward to seeing what that looks like and dipping my toes into that story mode and seeing what kind of havoc and mayhem we can cause. But good to see you, Stalk. Good to see you, Chrono Travis. Hey, Tom. Good to see you, too. Hope everybody's having a great Wednesday morning so far. I'll quit stalling and hop on into the game. All right, here we go. So let me see if I can actually get this running like I want it to. Just have to unpause. That seems like a basic feature. Okay, here we go. Loading up. I played a little bit of this one just to get a feel for what the controls look like, and it's a little clunkier than some. Hey, Nathan, good to see you. Good morning to you, too. Hope you're doing well this morning. All right. So normally I think we'd have awesome menu music once we jump in here, but I've turned all of that down to avoid DMCA strikes, so we're going to settle for whatever music it gives us. Jax Pacific. Great font. Future media creators. Ooh. All right. I believe this came out for Xbox 362, but we're playing the PlayStation 2 version today. A little easier to emulate. Yeah, here we go. Okay, this feels like it's probably music. Yeah, that sounds like it's licensed music, doesn't it? All these logos are a real vibe, aren't they? Okay, let's jump on in. We're going to try to avoid getting yeeted off of Twitch over SmackDown versus Raw 2007. All right, so we're going to go straight to season mode. I know that I could do an exhibition match and really get some experience and learn how the buttons work. But where's the fun of that? Actually, what we should do is take a look at what the roster's like, just to remind ourselves of what WWE was doing in 2007, a time that I definitely was not watching wrestling. So, okay, we got some Undertaker, we got some Viscera, some Vito, William Regal, Candice Michelle, Jillian, Mickey James, we got Trish Stratus. Oh, we got a locked Bam Bam Bigelow. Cactus Jack, Hitman Hart. Oh, we've got Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, if you will. Let's see. Eddie Guerrero. Got locked Hulk Hogan. Jerry Lawler. Oh man, Mankind, Mr. Perfect. Rowdy Roddy Piper. Oh, look at all these great popular wrestlers I will not be able to wrestle as because they're currently locked out. Boy, wouldn't you love when you bought your big WWE game to be able to play as The Rock or Steve Austin? Sorry, you're going to have to log like 25 hours in it before we let you touch those characters. But you do get Caribbean Cool Carlito. So, you know, it's got that going for it. All right. This is quite a roster. Lots of characters to choose from. There's John Cena, Johnny Nitro, Kane, the demonic Kane. Cheat codes, I don't think there are any. I looked this up. There's one that, like, is very sketchy and doesn't seem to do anything. But, yeah, so we got a lot. Oh, Ric Flair. Got Shawn Michaels looking not his best. Super Crazy, the Boogeyman. Man, look at this roster. Triple H. All right, here we go. So enough of that, though. We got to jump into this season mode and see what sort of havoc we can get into. We're going to start a new season mode. We're going to go difficulty easy because I just want to blow through this thing. And we are going to play as... Having looked over that entire roster, we're going to play as Mick Foley. An overall 88 score. Let's see here. Actually, let me just look real quick. How does 88 say stack up against Undertaker? Oh, Undertaker's one better. Oh, well. We'll have to make do with what we can. All right. We're going to start on SmackDown. Here we go. Let's get this story mode going. Oh, no. The story mode starts with the Rabid Wolverine, Chris Benoit. Immediately problematic. There's the desiccated corpse of Nature Boy Ric Flair. All right. So this is a good story mode right away because you have a computer and a desk you have to access things through. Okay, let's see here. So I guess we can buy stuff in the shop. We can access all the hottest stuff on the internet. Ooh, we have new phone messages. Let's make a deal, playa. Mick Foley, Theodore Long here, general manager. I've been taking special notice of your in-ring work this of late. Safe to say I've been more than a little impressed. If you get 4 wins, including one at the upcoming PPV, I'll reward you with a shot at the title. Get to breaking necks and cashing checks. All right, that's... Okay, I know that we've got a match coming up between Chris Benoit and The Undertaker. Don't have a single referee who's willing to step in the middle of them. They need us to be special guest referee, so we'll do it. We'll do it. Oh, story mode where you're running around doing backstage mini quests like a Yakuza game. I would be all in for that. You know, for a little while there, me and my friends who did StairQuest together were working on a wrestling adventure game and never really got much further than like one demo room, but it was pretty exciting. Maybe someday we'll return to it. It was a fun project to tinker around with. Okay, so I'm special ref in this match between Chris Benoit and The Undertaker. Rest in... peace.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another edition of SmackDown. This is Michael Cole here with my broadcast partner, Taz at ringside. And Taz, how'd you like to be in this man's shoes tonight?
I can't believe you even asked that, Cole. If you're willing to be the special referee in a match between Benoit and Taker, you're either stupid or crazy. And here I was thinking Ken Long actually liked this guy. I don't envy him one bit.
So all the other faces of Foley are locked out right now. We just get original flavor Mick Foley. No Cactus Jack, no Dude Love, no Mankind. We'll have to settle for him in his weakest form. General Manager Mick Foley. Dude Love may be his weakest form, in all fairness. Okay. Here comes Chris Benoit. Atlanta, Georgia.
Chris Benoit.
I'm sure this looks better on a CRT. Probably less of this, like, bloom effect would be noticeable.
Just
that. Let's bring out the Undertaker. Yeah, it doesn't look bad for PS2, does it? For 2006? But that's toward the end of the PS2's run, right? When did PS3 come along? I have no idea. All right.
And the opponent from Death Valley, weighing in at 305 pounds, The Undertaker.
Grayson, that is the correct answer. The PS3 came out about 4 years ago emotionally. I agree 100%. Oh, no, Grayson, you're so right. As always, Grayson nails it. Everyone, if you aren't already, let me give a shout out here. Be sure to go follow Hurdle Tomorrow, Grayson's new channel, Intruder Cloud, where he's been streaming some fun games in recent weeks. Usually on Thursday nights, but not always, but if you haven't already, drop over and give Grayson Turtle Tomorrow a follow at Intruder Cloud. It's good stuff. The hottest new channel on Twitch, I would say. Just coming off of a scintillating playthrough of Alone in the Dark. So, is the Undertaker actually an Undertaker, or is he someone who's dead and has been undertaken? Do we know the answer to that for sure? Are we supposed to believe that prior to wrestling he was in the business of like undertaking? Boy, this isn't drawn out, is it? Look at that ring announcer. Got that dead-eyed stare going on. Oh, he rolled his eyes back down. That's true. Paul Bearer, his manager for the longest time, was, in fact, a mortician, right? Ooh, I undertake. No, that's more Cedric than Paul Bearer. Although, really, Cedric and Paul Bearer aren't that far apart, now that I think about it.
Michael Cole and Taz at ringside for an unbelievable evening of SmackDown action.
Hey, Cole, this Miami crowd is all
so I'm special up. Referee.
They can't wait for the show to start. I'll tell you what, when this bad boy ends, I'm going to South Beach.
That makes ooh, two of us, Taz, and I know a backbreaker. Referees aren't supposed to do that.
What are we waiting for? He's got to be careful. If he retaliates, he could be disqualified.
I'm pointing at my pants. A dropkick to the back. How can we expect this referee to play fair?
This is the last time we see these superstars face off.
You're not going to hear me say this much, Cole, but I definitely agree with you.
Oh, all the makings of Undertaker's walking the ropes.
I don't know how nice it is, but there are certainly some issues between these superstars. And here we go with the submission hold. This could be a pivotal moment in this match.
It sure could. There's a lot of pressure being applied in that hold.
So I've decided to side with the Undertaker on this one. Chris Benoit locks up. A kick to the solar plexus. Oh! And a knee whip, a dragon knee whip. Mick Foley comes in. Oh, with a punch to Benoit's head. Just when Benoit had some momentum going, Mick Foley, the crooked referee, comes in with a back break. Oh, a back drop. Oh, my goodness. The pure force with which he hit the ground. Uh-oh, I'm out of breath already. I have to regain stamina.
This has been a great match so far. But I think it's pretty
Taz cool. Says this has been a great match so far. Undertaker. Oh, he crotches him on the ropes. Oh, no. Accidentally hit the Undertaker. Whose side is Mick Foley on? Oh, what's going on here? What does all this mean?
And he's got a lot to be confident about.
Yeah, well, he looks a little overconfident to me, Cole.
Okay. Undertaker. Oh, with a backbreaker. Chris Benoit's back. has to be feeling this by now. Mick Foley locks on a chin lock. A submission hold that no one has ever submitted to. It really makes you wonder why any wrestler would use it.
It sounds like this capacity crowd is something on their mind.
Playing your very first match in a story mode as a guest referee is an interesting choice. Another backbreaker. Uh-oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are seeing an incredible display.
I've got a finisher.
What's
Undertaker going for? Oh, he crotched him on the ropes again? Oh, now he's doing the thing. Oh, no. Oh,
Benoit.
And we lock on the chin lock again. How do I pick up a person from the ground? That's what I'd really like to do. So, you lock up in this game using the right analog stick, which is a weird control choice. I don't know if it works particularly well. Oh! Come on! Undertaker! Oh, he's got a choke. That's right, with me out, they can get away with anything. Uh-oh, Undertaker with the front chancery. Works the arm. Oh, some sort of wild arm lift flip.
To me, like you might be choosing the path of least resistance, if you know what I'm saying.
Oh, I doubt that very much, Taz.
Oh, he's giving the Boston Crab.
Any chances with this submission, Cole? Look at how tight he's got it locked
in. Benoit won't be able to withstand that for long. Foley drops the elbow.
These superstars give everything they got when they're in a match like this.
Foley with just a little reminder of the Undertaker. Ooh. Kidney punch.
No question. If you want to make it in the WWE,
pulls him to the center of the ring. Foley locks on that one chin. Lock again because I can't figure out how to pick up my opponent. Oh, here we go. Will he submit? Will he tap? Undertaker looks like he's built up enough momentum to drop his finisher.
The thing you gotta remember about the Undertaker is that 50% of his style, his offense, is about getting.
Uh-oh. Mick Foley. Oh, the double arm DDT. That's his big move. Undertaker whips him into the ropes. Locks on a headlock. This is a special ref match, so technically I'm supposed to just be watching this as Mick Foley, but instead, Mark, I am cheating on Undertaker's behalf.
I think these fans have got a little something they want to share with us.
That's their right, Taz. They paid for their tickets after all.
He's going to run the ropes. Uh-oh. Undertaker. Looks like he has the finisher. Oh, it's a tombstone pile driver. He's in the ropes. Oh, no. That's poor ringmanship by Undertaker. He knows better. Holy, oh, with the punishing clothesline. Yeah, that's an interesting way to think about this. I didn't consider it as a tutorial. That makes a lot of sense.
Just about the last hole you want to find yourself in.
I can imagine.
Do I have like a list of controls? Nope, just control tap A.
Just look at the pressure being applied here.
I gotta tell you, Cole, I thought I had this thing figured out.
Okay. Another backbreaker. Press X to heel turn out of the gate.
I've seen superstars get a huge advantage over their opponents and still.
Oh, Benoit with some momentum.
Anything can happen in WWE. An entire match can turn on one or two.
All right, Undertaker's got his finisher ready again. Can he put him away now? Okay, he's putting it in. Okay, now Undertaker walk to the center of the ring. Oh.
He wasted no time going for that pin.
Oh, the fast count. Oh, man. Mick Foley with a fast count. Benoit is not going to be happy with that decision. Undertaker wins. What an easy payday for Mick Foley. All right. I love his Sarah tattoo.
The Undertaker.
Let's see if I'm going to find the actual controls for this thing. Maybe I need to know how to pick people up off the ground. Let's see. Okay. Wow, this has, like, controls that last several pages of content. Okay, lift opponent to sitting position. Pick opponent up. Press right stick. Oh, I actually have to, like, press down the button? Gross. Ugh. I don't like any command that involves pressing down one of the analog sticks. Undertaker, fan of Sarah Records. Checks out. Let's see. What happens in this mode? I don't think anything useful. I think it's the phone we want to pay attention to. We are getting emails. It's only 2007. But we are definitely getting text messages.
Player, I don't know what the heck you were thinking last week, but you landed yourself in a whole lot of hot water. All I asked you to do was to call that match right down the middle. But I guess the Undertaker didn't see it that way. Anyway, you've got the dead man mad at you. And that's like signing your own death warrant. He's asked for a match against you. And there ain't no way I'm gonna tell that man no.
Makes
but
sense.
Here's the really scary part. No one's seen Benoit since last week's match.
Okay, here we go. We're gonna wrestle the Undertaker now, I think. That is a fancy computer, isn't it? That's a nice looking PC. Begin the week. I'm sure I want to begin my... You know, I wish every week came with a prop. Like every Monday morning, I want to wake up and I want someone to say, are you sure you want to begin your week? No. All right, so got Mick Foley versus The Undertaker. Yeah, simulate week would be pretty good. All right, let's skip that entrance. We saw it last time. We know what it's all about. Spooky. Spooky.
You know, I thought I felt sorry for this man last week when he had to referee one of the Undertaker's matches. But now he's got to compete in one.
Well, that's what happens when you try to play favorites as a stuck referee.
I'm not even sure that he played favorites back. This could all be some sort of misunderstanding. But nevertheless, I guess we all understand now why no one else wanted to referee that match last week.
Shouldn't Benoit be the one who's mad at me? You think Undertaker would be like, thanks a lot, Mick. All right, let's do this thing. So it's me and you, Undertaker. Taker didn't want my help. Taker could have done that on his own. Oh, no. Hey, thank you, Adobe Creative Cloud. I'm glad you're taking this opportunity to update. What a useful auto update system. Okay.
I'm Michael Cole alongside Taz, and we welcome you to Portland, Oregon. It's been a long time since we've come.
Oh, they're ready to square off.
It's great to be back.
No doubt, Cole. Tonight, the Rose City.
Okay, Undertaker. Oh, Foley. Pops off immediately.
Or we might have a riot on our hands. Come on, ref. That should have been a
decision. Oh, that is a dirty move. Foley already taking it to the Undertaker.
Man, I'm telling you, from my in-ring experience,
oh,
you can cut this tension with a knife.
Big Foley dressed appropriately for Portland circuit 2007. That checks out.
I disagree, Taz. Getting the crowd on your side can be a huge psychological boost.
Oh, no. Oh, we've locked up. Ooh.
This has been a great match so far, but I think it's pretty obvious which way it's going.
Oh, really? Are you willing to go out on a limb and actually...
Oh, wow. Undertaker counters Mick Foley's ugly dropkick, but he wasn't ready for it that time. Oh, just another hit right to the face.
Watching these
superstars go at it reminds me why I prefer to stay.
Ooh, chop, chop, chop. And, oh, head punch. Mick Foley's go-to move. Mick Foley's out of breath. He has to hold his stamina button for a minute. Just like in real life. Oh, hits to the lower back. Undertaker really taking some punishment here. Foley taunting, pointing to where he sorts his secret sock that he uses to apply his finisher. Uh-oh. Oh, Mick Foley slips out of the ring. Okay, Mick Foley needs to mix up his arsenal here. How does Undertaker have more momentum than me? Mick Foley takes him up. Oh, big backdrop. Mick Foley out of breath again. Boy, a stamina feature is a lot of fun in a wrestling game. Russian leg sweep. Drops the elbow. Drops an inexplicable elbow. Oh, and a nice little takedown. Foley, bang, bang! All right, Foley seems to have gained his finisher. Oh no, Undertaker did the zombie sit up. Uh-oh, here comes the mandible claw! Oh, but right into the ropes. What a mistake by Mick Foley. Wasting his big move.
I've said it before, and I'll say it again. Nothing costs you a match quicker than overcome.
Bang, bang!
I see a dominant superstar.
Uh-oh. Who's right. Uh-oh. Quit taunting. There's no taunt break. Okay. Build up some stamina.
Man, this match is so good. It's even worth sitting next to you to watch it, Cole.
Mick Foley's dropkick is pretty hilarious in this game.
You know what you should do, girl pants? You should team up with Jerry Lawler. Then you can be the king and queen on commentary.
All right.
You know, that would almost be worth not having to work with a joker like you all.
I've seen matches.
Nope, not what I wanted to do. Not what I wanted to do at all. Oops, sorry, ref. Oops, I just murdered the ref. Oh no, Undertaker clipping through the ropes.
And I'm glad to see it. A WWE match isn't just about competition, it's also about entertaining the fans.
Okay, well, if that's the case, how come they got you as an announcer? I mean, that ain't exactly great entertainment, in my opinion.
You might be right, Taz.
Boy, this commentary is something else. Okay, gotta get my stamina back up. Again, Mick Foley, not in the best shape of his career in 2007. Needs constant stamina rebuild. Uh-oh, Undertaker goes around. Whips Mick Foley into the corner. Undertaker fails to capitalize. Mick Foley seems to have had some sort of odd moment. Okay, front chancery hookup. Undertaker going old school. He's walking the ropes.
That's why you see so much passion.
Oh.
In the ring.
And that's something you won't see.
That's a ridiculous move.
With all due respect to every athlete.
It really takes you out of the moment when you see it in an actual wrestling match. When the Undertaker does the walk the rope bit, I would argue it's terrible. It requires his partner to help him do it. And it doesn't look like it's painful anyway. It's a high-risk maneuver with no apparent payoff in the world of wrestling. Like, if you take this as a real athletic competition, that would be a poor choice to make. Okay, here comes the claw again. That's pinning. Is he ready to be pinned? Ah, the Undertaker's so tall, everywhere's a rope break. Don't know what happened there.
The Undertaker is that 50% of his style is off. is about getting inside the head of his opponent. If you can keep your cool and keep your, you know, keep your head together.
Oh, working the arm of the Undertaker. Mick Foley out of breath again, about to pass out.
Surely you can't forget about that.
Well, you see, that's the other 50%.
Mick Foley somehow has his finisher again. Okay, here we go. Just gonna rest up, let the Undertaker lay outside the ring for a little while. He comes back in. We're going to hit our big finish right in the middle of the ring. He's going to tap out, and Mick Foley will have defeated the Dead Man. Come on, Taker.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are seeing an incredible display of athletic ability.
We really are.
What do you expect, Paul? He's a WWE superstar, for crying out loud. They're the greatest athletes in the world.
True enough, Taz. There's no off-season for them.
Oh, Mick Foley with who had the submission on the leg. That's not going in this match.
The submission hold is locked in.
And this ain't easy to get out of either, Cole. I've been looking forward to this match all night long, Cole.
So have I. It's certainly been one of the most...
Mick Foley with a flurry of blows.
And usually when you have that...
But now too tired to move. Oh, the slump down. I'm too tired to function thing is great. Okay. So theoretically, I have a finisher loaded up. We're in the First Amendment in action, says Michael Cole. Uh-oh. Once again, in the corner where this move can't possibly give him the win, Mick Foley, not understanding the geography of the ring.
But now I got no idea how this is gonna...
Look at him, he's just radiating confidence.
Just radiating confidence. You know me. Okay, get my stamina back. Undertaker, you don't have much left, I feel like.
Man, I can't tell you how impressed I am.
Okay.
How could you not be impressed, Taz? These are some of the greatest superstars in the world. Doing what they do best.
Hey, slow down, girl pants. I went into this expecting okay. a match. I'm just saying, it's even better.
I think Taz keeps calling Michael Cole girl pants as an insult.
Fans are fired up now. They sure are, and you know that's going to have
an
effect on this match.
Foley locks up. Ooh, just a punch to the belly.
You know, there's no doubt that The Undertaker is one of the most impressive ever to set foot.
This turned one of those streams with the tiny gameplay window. Well, with a 4-3 game, you know, I don't want to stretch it out to fill the full window and have everything look all weird and stuff like that. But, so, you know, a 4-3 game is only going to take up a certain portion of the screen. So I feel like rather than just having empty space elsewhere, getting the chat and the cam over there makes sense.
But you know what, Cole? You're only as good as your last match.
How can you say that, Taz? The Dead Man has proven himself time and time again.
Good to see you, Sue Jack.
That would change if he lost this match, which I don't think he's in danger of doing, by the way.
His
okay, I need to put this away. Oh, man, come on. You gotta be kidding me.
I can't believe you could sit here and even imply that The Undertaker might
be... Play two PS2 games at once. With the same inputs. I wonder if that'd be possible. I just trapped at him. Come on.
And there's the pin. He anticipated that move. Wow.
What?
I thought he had the pin for sure.
Mick Foley really starting to show signs of fatigue himself after being on The Undertaker for 10 minutes straight. Oh, Undertaker. The punch to the gut. Oh, double arm DDT. That should be enough to finish it.
They didn't, they wouldn't be here.
Man. Okay, here we go. You know, Sujak, you say the beautiful stream overlays of a pixel art Amiga with a tiny gameplay window. I may know possibly exactly what stream you're talking about if that's a specific
Here's
example. All right, we got the big win. Got the big win. Undertaker sent home. Yeah, I know of at least one Amiga streamer who does the itty-bitty window. lots of pixel art, big old camera.
What? I didn't sabotage your match. You don't believe me? Fine. You don't scare me, dead man.
Yeah. Oh no, he's making the lights flicker.
Come on.
Out of my way, Junior. I want a rematch, Taker, without your flunky here.
What? Bring it.
Is that right?
I want a title match, Taker. Just you and me, so leave your little punk out.
Hey, what the hell?
Get your damn hands off me. You are mine, dead man.
Wow. You see, that's why you play a good story mode. You want cutscenes like that. That's what makes a wrestling game great. All right, let's begin our week. Not Kojima, the guest producers. That makes sense. All right.
I'm sick of you ducking me, Undertaker. You know I'm the most dominant superstar in SmackDown, and you know you can't prove me wrong.
You think I'm afraid of you, little man? I can't count the number of superstars who have tested themselves against the dead man and come up short. If you insist on making this mistake, then your grieving family will have no one to blame but you when the inevitable occurs.
What's happening? Who's here? Teddy Long, General Manager.
General Manager Teddy Long.
Let me holler at you, players. Now, you've obviously got some unfinished business with each other, and I respect that. But I also respect that there's a third superstar involved in this who would not have been involved if I didn't make him the special referee for your match 2 weeks ago. So tonight, for our main event, I'm giving him the chance to prove himself against you, Benoit, one-on-one. And I've got some big plans for No Mercy that involve the three of you. Holla, holla, holla.
Yes. Holla, holla, holla to you too.
I have no idea, partner, but if I know our general manager, they're going to be huge.
Okay, so now I have to beat up Chris Benoit. Is that what happens? Is that my next match? Yeah, the camera flash going through Benoit's head is pretty great. So this is going to run into a triple threat match at the pay-per-view, and those are awful in these games. Anything that's not a one-on-one match in every wrestling game immediately becomes more complicated than is worth playing. Like, tag team matches, awful. Like, cage matches, terrible. Triple threats, two-on-ones.
And the opponent, from Long Island, New York, Mick Foley.
All right, I'm very excited tonight for Day of the Tentacle. I can't wait. I am going to go on record saying I think Laverne from Day of the Tentacle has the greatest walk animation in video game history. And I'm looking forward to experiencing that again.
Good evening to our fans from Vancouver, British Columbia. Michael Cole and Taz at ringside, and what a show we've got for you tonight. Hey, partner?
Hey, Cole, it's pretty funny. You said, hey. You know, like the Canadians, they always go, hey. You know, hey.
Can I say, Taz?
Oh!
The enthusiasm of these Vancouver fans.
I reversed his reversal. No hamsters will be harmed. Not even for my dissection lab. Uh-oh. Oh, you can really feel the tension in the ring. These two performers. No love lost. Brush the leg sweep.
Is that much worse?
Emotional. Foley drops the elbow. Foley drops the elbow. Foley drops the elbow and nobody's home. Ooh, yeah, you know, Travis, I have both of those planned to stream as soon as they come out. So expect Space Venture stream, I guess, coming up in 2 weeks. Is that right? Uh-oh. Locks up. Oh, and a big side suplex. Oh, he locks on a submission. Benoit's in a submission specialist, so I have to get out of that. Really, the momentum's going in Benoit's direction. Foley doesn't connect with his strange dropkick, but he does that time.
But he also jumped back and forth between Raw and SmackDown more than any other superstar. It almost looks to me like he might be choosing the path of least resistance, if you know what I'm saying.
Oh, I doubt that.
Okay, he takes him up. Backbreaker.
He's no coward.
Whoa. Yeah, it's going to be out for backers on the 16th.
I'm just saying that he might have a knack for picking.
Looking forward to it. Yeah, I barely played the beta for Space Venture. Oh, look at this. Oh, what a move. What a maneuver. Oh, wow. You're at the 250 tier, Tom. That's pretty exciting. What comes at that tier? Oops. That shot the ramp out of the ring. The ref's dead. I'm sorry. Foley just did a murder. Ooh, behind the scenes commentary.
I think we're here.
It's definitely gonna be a doozy.
It's a great thing to hear, Paul. I'm all in favor of freedom of expression, whether I agree with what they're saying or not.
The game on DVD, wow.
These superstars are on. You know, you can show off for the crowd all you want, but all that does is let your opponent rest up.
Actually, Taz. I think it's a great display of confidence on the part of this great superstar.
I think I pledged at whatever tier got me a Buckazoid. I think that's where I topped out. I don't remember the dollar amount, but I know I had a Buckazoid on the way.
Man, I'll tell you what, man. This one's just turned into a fight. Pure and simple. We knew it was going to be intense.
We've seen this before.
Oh, no.
Whatever it takes to win and take every advantage he can.
Oh, you reversed my finisher. Who pledged to go to the launch party tier? I know at least one person who pledged $10,000 to Space Venture. I won't reveal their name on stream, but I do know someone who pledged $10,000 to Space Venture. Which, boy...
He can talk all he
wants. Even if that's the greatest game ever.
I think you're wrong about that, Taz. I think this is going to make his victory tonight that much sweeter. This capacity crowd is making their opinions known tonight.
No surprise there, Paul. The WWE fans ain't exactly known for keeping their opinions to themselves.
Hey, Savell, good to see you. Who you see their likeness is nailing, exactly.
I have no idea how this is going to end up.
Neither do I, Taz, but I think it's that unpredictability that makes it so exciting.
No doubt, Cole. I've seen superstars get a huge advantage over their opponents and still lose the match.
Okay. Oh, I'm going to hook on the mandible claw. This is the big finish. Will Benoit tap out?
And that's why you can't take your eyes off the action for one.
Is that not... submission in this game? It's just like a move? Alright. Fine. We'll just pin him. I bet Trolls has his likeness in the game somewhere, since we know that Mark Crow drew his character and he's been using it for his avatar and in all of his videos forever now. So we know that asset exists. Surely he's in the game. All right, welcome in, everybody, if you're just joining me. So glad you could be here. Oh, no, Chris Benoit. Got a big win there. Yeah, I'm really curious about Space Venture. Like I said, I didn't play much of the beta, like maybe literally less than 15 minutes. I just decided I didn't want to really spoil it for myself and just moved on from there, so... I'm curious to see what we've got on the way. Hope it's good. Okay, let's begin the week. Where's this heading? I guess it's heading toward a triple threat match. That would make the most sense. Uh-oh. Oh no, the lights are flickering again. The Undertaker's throwing a light switch rave party.
Save your hostility for the ring, Benoit.
I came to tell you that I look forward to laying our differences to rest at No Mercy.
Aren't you forgetting about somebody?
He is a distraction.
That's
this
me.
Began between the two of us, and by all rights, it should end between the two of us.
Yeah, I'm curious to see how much polish they were able to add since the beta, too.
Kind of alliance. Because I don't care which one of you I have to force to tap out tonight.
I'm not suggesting anything of the kind. I've said all I came to say. Actually, there is one more thing. I hope you have no
illusions
that
him.
Will make me submit tonight.
He's Columbo'd him. He one more thinged him. Oh no, he blew up one of the fluorescent light tubes. Oh no. You know, I hope that once Space Ventures out on Steam that they're able to make some sales there and recoup some of the development costs. I mean, even though they raised $500,000 over close to a decade, you know, that's no budget to accomplish anything in game development. So I'm hoping they're able to pay themselves. They're able to finish getting all the rewards out and everything. Yep, he Columbo'd him. Undertaker pulled a classic Columbo. Boy, this Ric Flair loading screen is upsetting.
Here comes Chris Benoit, Taz the Rabbit, and Wolverine looks even more intense and focused than usual for tonight's triple threat match.
Of course he does, Cole. There's a lot at stake here tonight. A lot of pride on the line.
Benoit must avoid losing to one of his opponents tonight in order to continue to No Mercy. And if he wins, he gets to choose the No Mercy match type.
Yeah, exactly. If you take that $500,000 and you spread it out over 10 years and simply paying three employees at a minimum, the money doesn't exactly work out to anyone running off to the bank or, you know, taking elaborate vacations on backers' dimes. All right. But trolls are gonna troll.
You gotta think that a triple threat match like this would favor a superstar like the Undertaker, Taz.
Ooh, man, I don't like this triple threat match.
The best of circumstances.
Maybe not. I know the other two guys in this match don't see eye to eye. But if they decide to team up against him, it could be bad news for the dead man.
I'm sure it's got to be a relief to ship the game finally for the two guys. I'm hoping that we'll see them do a little bit of press for the game. I know we haven't heard a lot from Mark or Scott in recent years, but I'm hoping they'll get out there and maybe talk to some of the news outlets and things like that and try to drum up some interest. It is wild that Space Venture and Monkey Island are coming out so close together. I wonder if they would have delayed Space Adventure another month or so to keep from being right on top of Return to Monkey Island, had they known in time. Okay. So here it is, the triple threat match. This is where my winning streak is going to almost certainly come to an end. I'll be knocked down, somebody else will pin somebody else. So I want to get out of this Chris Benoit storyline as quickly as possible. That's what needs to happen here. I need to move on to whatever the next storyline in this game is. It's hard to have much fun with Chris Benoit. Hey! I'm not sure who that is. Keep seeing him on the loading screen. I don't quite know where he is. Okay.
It's the city so nice they named it twice. Tonight, SmackDown comes to you from the Big Apple.
New York City.
Oh, wow. Are we at Madison Square Garden? And also a place that I'm proud this MSG?
Oh, no. Partner, and you know, it's always a huge event whenever...
Hey, Hot Shock, welcome in. How are you? Okay, it's time to figure out how to change who I'm looking at.
From my in-ring experience, trust me, you can cut this tension with a knife.
It does look pretty good, right?
Experience to feel the tenacity radiating off these superstars has. I don't think
Undertaker recently retired, supposedly.
He's never been in there, Cole. Trust me, when it comes down to you or them, it's a whole different level of intensity.
I'll have to take your word for it, Taz. I honestly can't imagine a more electric atmosphere than the
one. I can't figure out how to change directions. Okay. Big hit, big hit. Oh, and the ref goes down too. Ah, beans. I think it's automatically choosing who I'm targeting. Hey, well, welcome in. Glad to see you. I'm Jess. I like to play retro games, a little bit of everything. Glad you could be here. Oh, he brought Sweet Centric for the Alexander emotes. Thank you. Gotta love a good Cedric emote. I actually just added some new emotes this morning, some Day of the Tentacle emotes that are ready to go for when I stream that tonight. Oh, there's Laverne. There's what I'm looking for.
You just don't see action like this every day.
Ooh. Chop to the throat. Foley just dominating so far.
Whoa, that's your territory.
This is just dumb, Cole. You don't win a match by talking to a opponent to death.
I disagree, Taz. Getting the crowd on
the bugaloo.
Boost. This capacity crowd is making their opinions known tonight.
No surprise
there. Uh-oh. Got a submission locked in.
Ain't exactly known for keeping up. There's the submission hold.
Undertaker breaks it up. Okay, let's taunt.
You sure you can spare a call?
Oh no, we got tired from taunting. So let's rebuild our stamina.
I don't think there's ever been a more dominant superstar in WWE.
Bang, bang. Uh-oh, Undertaker takes him up. Oh no, he crotches him on the ropes. And now he's shaking the ropes like a monster. Oops,
oh, no.
Just murdered the referee.
What's going to happen now?
Anything and everything, Cole. No ref means no rules.
Talk about adding insult to injury. And these fans...
That rope shake didn't seem very severe. Nobody seemed to commit to it, really. Oh! That's a spicy meatball. Okay.
We all know that the competition on Raw isn't exactly impressive, and I think Benoit might have gotten a little rusty.
But what are you talking about? If anything, Benoit's become more impressive.
Ooh, big slap.
It's great to see him in action again tonight.
Okay. Got to figure out how to manage two opponents at once. Crotch punch.
And I hope he's proud of himself. Personally, I find
okay. Need to manage my opponents here. Okay, uh-oh, he goes for the mandible claw.
And
Mick Foley's tired. He's a tired boy. Needs to catch his breath.
It also means that if you're not at 100%, you've got to be able to hide it from your
I did not mean to do that. I'm likely to work. Foley recovers. Undertaker, you've probably been wild for a little while. I'll do this to you. Yeah, have another finisher ready. Oh, here it comes on the Undertaker this time. Ooh. Just chokes him out.
which I don't think he's in danger of doing, by the way.
Taker's earned his rep, no doubt about that. No one's disputing that. But you gotta know when to call it a day, Cole. There's a fine line between...
Oh, that's a rope break. No.
I can't believe
it's an Undertaker break. Okay, I gotta figure out a way to incapacitate one of these guys so I can pin the other one.
Hey, Cole, don't put words in my mouth. The dead man has been on top of this business for a very long time. But okay.
Ooh. Just adding insult to injury, and Mick Foley's tired again. Oops, sorry, ref. Russian leg sweep on the ref.
Oh my god, I think the referee's out, Taz.
I'll tell you, they gotta start getting sturdy at refs, Cole. This kind of thing seems to happen all the time.
Gotta get sturdier refs, says the commentary.
He's going for the pin.
Oh, there's no one there to make the count.
You know, Cole, I got a lot of respect for Chris Benoit, but he also jumped back and forth between Raw and SmackDown more than any other superstar. It almost looks to me like he might be choosing the path of least
resistance. All right, wow. Got another finisher already.
Chris Benoit never runs for... There's the pin!
What? Ah, Undertaker broke it up. Oh, man, that's annoying.
These WWE...
Alarm DDT! Oh, he locks in the Boston Crab. Oh, we call that a deadly submission hold. It's more like a rest hold.
The longer you stay in this, the more risk you have for serious injury.
I'm gonna make this work. I'm gonna go back to it right away. Too tired to move.
I see that, Taz. I wouldn't be surprised if he got his opponent to tap out right here.
Okay, Undertaker twisting the arm of Benoit. Whips Foley into the corner. Oh! Chris Benoit with the release suplex. What a maneuver. Benoit with some real energy coming back.
We knew it was going to be intense. We knew it was going to be physical. But I don't think anyone was prepared for... He smells...
Man, what do you like about these games? They always seem like they're making a sincere effort with an impossible task in a worst time. I mean, it's true. I mean, the real challenge is, like, for a sport that is completely fake, how do you choose to, like, combine the fake storylineness with something that approximates, like, an actual sports simulation? And then, yeah, with all the other complications you add to that, it is an unenviable task.
If you had a guess, 2 minutes into it.
You can say that again.
Okay.
Matches won and lost simply because one superstar...
Okay, Foley with the double punches.
And there's the pin!
Come on. Oh, I hate this. I hate triple threat matches in these games. They're always terrible.
...is about getting inside the head of his opponent. If you... This guy might not have enough to kick out.
Well, he goes for an unlikely pin. Okay, him takes out of the ring. This is the time. This is the time. Okay, do it.
He's got him covered.
One, two. Ah, he kicked out.
That was almost free.
No. Okay. Foley's got the finisher. Come on, come on, come on.
Chris Benoit's a great technical wrestler, no doubt about
it. Oh man, that was my chance and I blew it. Okay, double arm DDT. That's the big finish. Can he capitalize? No, he can't. He pushes the wrong button. Oh, you hate to see it. Nothing sadder than seeing a wrestler push the wrong button. And doing it twice in a row, even.
This is just about the last hole you want to find yourself in.
I can imagine. Just look at the pressure being...
Ah, come on, Undertaker. I'm just doing that move.
Submission. I ain't never seen it executed better.
Oops, sorry, ref.
And this might be enough to get the tap out right here.
Okay, hit the finish on the Taker. Then maybe I'll go pin Benoit. Hey, Benoit's up. This is gonna work though. I got it. This is the move. This is how it happens. Here we go. Now count it out, ref. Ah! No!
Hey, the ref's got a tough job. I mean, trying to keep these superstars on the up and up. That's hard.
Well, it's easier to get some superstars to play by the rules than others.
Hey, you know what, Cole? If you're going to get on your high horse again and give us another lecture about playing fair, I swear to God, I'm going to throw up.
Is it so wrong to ask a superstar to play by the rules, Taz?
It's so hard to ask a superstar to play by the rules.
Because you never competed in a match, Cole.
Okay, here's my chance. Here's my chance.
You know that you got to do whatever it takes to win. If that means bending the rules a bit, well, then that's just the way the cookie crumbles.
Okay, here we go. Okay, get him. No, that's all I meant to do. Okay, that'll work, though. Now, a crotch punch is always going to soften up your opponent a little.
How could the referee have missed that?
Okay, here it is. Right in the middle of the ring. Got this. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
They sure are. And you know that's going to have an effect on this match.
Don't rope break. Don't rope break. One, two, three. Woo! Ben. Seems like that's interesting, getting the license particular, right? Bunch of moves, outfits, beat up the ref. I'm sure the controls are completely... Yeah, I mean, this game has incredibly complicated controls. They're really confusing me.
Mick Foley.
Oh, yeah, I remember Warzone and Attitude. That was brutal, TL. I just got a text from my wife, who last night had a dream that we got in a fight with each other, and she just texted me to say that she had forgiven me for what I did in her dream last night. So I feel pretty good right now. My wife is no longer angry at me for something I absolutely did not do in the real world. So I'm having a pretty good day, folks. She absolutely woke up mad at me from the dream. Yeah, she... like, very mad. Like, I mean, well, like, reasonably so. Like I said, it's like, I know this doesn't make any sense, but I'm still just, like, really upset with you. So, but now I'm off the hook. Everything's fine. All right. Seeing you getting the job done every week on SmackDown. Don't get too distracted by the bright lights and beautiful ladies. On my last count, you still need one more win, plus one at the PPV to keep up your end of the deal and get a shot at the title. All right, am I done fighting Benoit and Undertaker, please? Like, is that a possibility? Hey, Bogus Meat Factory. Yeah, the AKI games are fantastic. You know, NWO versus WCW, WCW World Tour, No Mercy, WrestleMania 2000. I still think those are the best wrestling games ever made in terms of a combination of strategy and fun arcade action. Okay. Now you've just got one more match tonight. No Mercy to prove you're a genuine SmackDown main eventer. What kind of match is it going to be, playa? I hope it's just a one-on-one against a jobber. I want a squash match here at the PPV. Begin our week. See what happens. Mick versus Benoit. A singles match. Oh. Sweet. So it's just a straight up match? No shenanigans? No gimmicks? I don't have to like set my opponent on fire to win? It's not a first blood match or anything like that? It wasn't a first blood match, was it?
Chris Benoit has a great deal of confidence in his abilities, but I've never got the sense that he's got a swell head pass.
Hey, Kevin.
This thing that they had going with The Undertaker, it wasn't about talking trash. It was about getting the respect he deserves for the career he's had.
And tonight at No Mercy could be another one of the many high points in the career of Chris Benoit.
Okay, here we are at the PPV, the pay-per-view. This is their chance to get a big win. Ooh, Def Jam Fight for New York. You know, that's one I've wanted to check out. I feel like it's probably got so much licensed music, it's hard to stream.
I don't have to take anything away from it, Taz, but I don't think many people expected him to make it to No Mercy.
I gotta agree with you. Again, nothing against the guy, but he went up against two of the greatest superstars in the history of the business. I gotta say, I'm impressed.
Okay. Okay, here we are. It's time for the big match. So, hey, there's Matt Hardy. Before he was broken. Before he was woken. Okay, here goes. Good luck, I say to myself. What's going to happen? Big pay-per-view event. Look at him. Such intensity. Foley with a big drop kick to start. Transitions into a backbreaker.
It's so great seeing these athletes compete here tonight.
Drops his Foley butt on the Benoit. Chop, chop, chop. Woo! Oh! Foley sends Benoit out of the ring. Foley taunting. Works the arm.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other.
That's the law of the jungle, Cole. And injured superstars like a wounded...
Okay, I'm out of stamina already. Too much action.
And that also means that if you're not at 100%, you've got to be able
takes
to
him down
from your opponent.
You got that right, Cole. This business is a psychological...
Flips him over. Oh, working the knee. Locks on submission. Attempting to submit a technical wrestler like Benoit. No easy task.
There's a lot of pressure being applied in that hole, Cole. Whoa! A textbook reversal. Can he follow up?
Oh no. Oh no. No, not like this. No. Oh no! Benoit with a big body slam. BBS. Foley taps out of the ring real quick. Comes back in. He's back. Oh, he's moving with such speed and grace. Oh, big slap. Showing no respect for his opponent. Pulls him up. Oh, punishing fist to the head.
I'll tell you what, let me talk about what it's like to be in a match like this, and you can cover what it's like.
Excuse me, ref. I'm trying to beat someone up.
He's taking a little time to give his opponent a piece of his mind.
That's right. I mean, he's pointing at the sweat sock that's in his pants. That is part of his inexplicable finishing move, but it's just strange out of context, really. Oh, I tried to reverse that. I don't want a side slam. No, that was Eric Bischoff, the cool WCW owner who joined the NWO. Eric Bischoff.
I've seen a lot of superstars tap out to this one, Cole.
Okay. Armbar!
Another one right here.
There we go. Okay, let's get it, Mick. I need you to...
I think Benoit might have lost a step or two when he took that little vacation okay. from SmackDown. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, Benoit has a much worse story, which is why I'm glad this storyline is apparently about to end. Oh, he dodged my finisher.
What are you talking about? If anything, Benoit's become more impressive since he went to Raw. It's great to see him in action again tonight. Sounds like this capacity crowd is something on their minds, Taz.
Yeah, and thousands of paying customers can't be wrong.
Oh, wow, look at this. Foley bounces off the ropes. Oh! Drops all 300 pounds on Benoit.
Tough guys, but these superstars are really raising the bar here tonight.
They sure are, Taz. We're seeing some great intensity here tonight.
Okay, Foley really, really putting it to Benoit here.
That's exactly what they've got in mind.
Okay, Foley stomps him out of the ring.
He can talk all he wants, Cole, but once he's lost the match, this guy's gonna...
I don't know. Bret Hart has something going for him, Sue Jack. I mean, Bret Hart is one of those guys who's really good at making you believe for a moment that maybe this sport isn't predetermined. He's got that believability that... You know, I think as a kid, I kind of decided he was not as cool as a lot of his opponents, like Shawn Michaels or Stone Cold Steve Austin. But as I've grown older and occasionally gone back to watch some of his matches, there's a believability there that I think makes him pretty special. He is the excellence of execution, after all.
You just can't put anything over on these fans.
You sure can't. They see everything, and they'll let you know about it.
Okay. Grabbing the Boston Crab. Oh, wow. Bubba's got him to tap out. Oh, man. Benoit. That's a bad way to go out. Ooh. He tapped out Boston Crab a few minutes into the match. Ooh. Wow.
It was the man standing victorious in the ring right there. Well, one thing for sure.
I'm the baddest man on SmackDown now. Wow. Y'all, I can't believe that we came out with a win there, but here we are. Ooh, we get the No Mercy Arena, and we've unlocked the Diva package in the WWE shop. What's that, you might ask? Well, I don't know. Let's begin our week. Wow, 1 week later. Uh-oh. What's happening? Ooh. I'm excited to no longer have to face Benoit and the Undertaker. I'm ready for literally anyone else. Let's see what happens if what the Diva package is. Does that just unlock a bunch of wrestlers? Does it give me create a wrestler stuff? Oh, is that really it? I get loading screens? If you want to see hot ladies in your loading screens. Oh, gosh, that's hilarious. So, yeah, what I unlocked by winning that pay-per-view match is the ability to add the women wrestlers to the loading screens. Ooh, early WWF fandom, the Ultimate Warrior. Yeah, you know, I was big into NWA or WCW back in the 80s. So I was like watching Ric Flair and Sting. They were always my go-to wrestlers. I kind of missed the Ultimate Warrior era, unfortunately. Well, I guess I'll buy it. Sure, why not? Now we have Diva loading screens. Y'all, this is going to be great. Just wait until you see women join the men on the loading screens. Okay, to the future of SmackDown. Where are your title shot? Oh. Okay, so is this the title match coming up? Could that be? Are we getting ready to have a title match? Yeah, for me, that was the big thing with WCW. It came on TBS here in the U.S. on Saturday nights, which was an easy time for me to catch it. So I kind of ended up, locking into that more than the WWF as a kid. Okay, I've got your back. Ooh, a new storyline starts. You can't see him. There's no loading screen there, I'm sorry. What's new? How's this work? What's it want me to look at? What's new on the internet? Ooh, Mick Foley's named the number one contender. Oh, for Chris Benoit's heavyweight title. Oh, Johnny Nitro doesn't like it. So Johnny Nitro says, why not me? Hey, Oscar. Hello. How are you doing? Welcome from Spain. Good to see you. Welcome in. All right, so I guess we're going to have to work up to facing Benoit for his title. Benoit. So here we go. We're jumping in. We're going to fight Johnny Nitro, a.k.a. John Morrison. Demonic Kane. Now mayor of Knoxville. The mayor of a fairly large city in Tennessee.
Oh,
this entrance.
And here comes the man who thinks that he should be the number one contender for Chris Benoit's World Heavyweight title at Survivor Series, Johnny Nitro.
And hey, why not? The guy's no stranger to gold. Take him gold, at least.
He's young and he's hungry, and he's got something to prove here tonight in this match.
Yeah, Johnny Nitro's gone through every name imaginable. Then Johnny Impact, at least for a little while, right? The mayor of Slamville, the Slam Town. He's the mayor of one of those towns, much like Kane is the mayor of Knoxville. Oh yeah, Clash at the Castle coming up. Is that this weekend or next weekend? Who's the barber beefcake? Oh. It does kind of look like a werewolf coat. Thank you for the sticker, Lucy. Good to see you. Welcome, welcome. Hope you're having a great day. All right, here goes Mick. Now, I really want to win this title now. Okay, time to beat up Johnny Nitro. Just finished work. All right. Yeah, I have a little bit of the morning off today, so I'm using it in the most valuable way possible.
A big Southern California welcome to all our...
Glad you can drop in.
I'm Michael Cole, here with Taz at ringside in San Diego.
Big shout out to all our great fans in the 619.
Oh!
I love San Diego, baby.
Foley already taunting by pointing down his pants.
And we couldn't be more excited to be here.
The Mankind fingers in the throat thing was never cool. The mandible claw, yes. Uh-oh. Big reversal.
You're not always my number one choice for a broadcast partner, right?
You know what you should do, girl pants? You should team up with Jerry.
Oh, Nitro's got some fire in the tank. That's not how that phrase works, is it?
You know, that would almost be worth not having to...
He's been looking for that all match, Cole.
Oh! Delivering the pain. Oh, returning the favor. Johnny Nitro has some spunk. I hate spunk.
That was a textbook reversal. And there's the counter.
Oh, big reversal. Into a backbreaker.
I love hearing the crowd come alive, even when I don't exactly agree with what they're saying.
Me too. And I do agree with what they're saying, Taz. Superstars face off.
You're not going to hear me say this much, Cole, but I definitely agree with you.
What's the question, Hot Shot? Does that say pretend to wrestle at some point?
Nice it is, but there are certainly some issues between these superstars, and I think this match might only exasperate them.
Please, Cole, watch your language, will you? It's a family show.
I said exasperate. Not, oh, never mind.
Okay.
Johnny Nitro is an incredibly talented superstar, but it's almost impossible for me to get past that.
He can talk all he wants, Cole.
Oh, no. I don't think I said that. If I did, I didn't mean to.
I think you're wrong about
predetermined that. Certainly doesn't mean fake by any means.
That much sweeter.
Oops, sorry, Rap. That wasn't supposed to be for you. Russian leg sleep. Ooh, on the concrete.
A little something for the fans.
Who
cares what they think? All she's doing here is giving us...
Okay, get my stamina back. Well, he's taking a powder.
We can afford to ignore these fans, Cole.
Bang, bang!
Say it again. Nothing costs you a match quicker than over...
Boy, the commentators really don't appreciate it when I talk.
Superstar who's rallying this capacity crowd behind him.
Ooh, big arm drag. Followed by a solid clothesline from Foley.
Actually, Taz, I think it's a
Oh, I think it was, I think that I probably said that about Bret Hart earlier. Really selling the realism of the sport.
Johnny Nitro struts around here like he's God's gift to sports entertainment, and I don't mind telling you that makes me sick.
Of course, it makes you sick, Cole. Every time you see
he's slapping on the mandible claw, as always, right in the ropes. Rope break.
What are you talking about, dummy? What are you talking about? Between his WWE career and his high
okay.
I'm sure Nacho takes home a pretty decent paycheck, unlike the pennies you make.
This capacity crowd is making their opinions known tonight.
No surprise there, Cole. The WWE fans ain't exactly known for keeping their opinions to them. What a reversal.
Oh, no. Oh, he's reversing out of it. Okay.
But only one of them is gonna
Foley going up top and ill-advised high-risk maneuver, and he comes back down for some reason because I don't understand all the controls.
Man,
oh, Nitro with a reversal.
A match like this, you're gonna be feeling for the next week.
Yes, look at these fans. They didn't like that one bit.
Yeah, well, you know what? I got some.
Ooh, we've got our finisher back.
Fans, he don't give a damn what you think.
I didn't mean to cover. Could be a win anyway. Nope, didn't think so. Didn't think so. He just tap L1 to complain to the referee. I wonder what that does. By the way, good to see everyone. Thanks for joining me this morning. I'm not normally on Wednesday morning, so it's always good to see people able to drop by. Backbreaker. Okay, Foley. Oh, just wrenching at the arm. Stone Cold is in this game, but unfortunately he's a locked character that you have to play all the way through story mode to access, I believe. Okay, double arm DDT. DDP, that should be it. A DDT, I said DDP. Look. All right, there we go. Rob Van Dam. All right, we're making great progress through this story. Uh-oh. Foley's celebrating.
Whoa, listen to these WWE fans.
Oh, no.
What
no, don't do it.
Doing with that chair?
Johnny Nitro.
Obvious, lady.
Okay.
You know, I've got to admit that you really showed me something out here today. And maybe you do deserve to be the number one contender. But, dude... we've seriously got to work on that image. And that's where I come in.
Oh, please.
Look, you're a pretty tough guy. But you've got all the personality of a block of wood. I mean, seriously. You're all steak, no sizzle. Stick with me. I'll teach you how to break necks in the ring and give the women whiplash on Hollywood Boulevard. I'll make you a star because you're good for business. And what's good for business is good for all of us.
All right, well, we've got an image consultant.
Johnny Nitro says he's going to help mold him into a true world heavyweight champion.
You don't seriously think that Nitro's onto something here, do you? Aren't you supposed to be Mr. It's what you do in the ring that matters?
Okay, this storyline sounds like a good start. So Johnny Nitro is going to teach us how to manage our image. Let's see here. Oh, we've got a new cell phone message. Hey, champ.
Hey, champ. I hear you're locking up with Benoit in a non-title match tonight. Try not to let him land too many face shots, because I know this guy who's going to do a photo shoot for us tomorrow as a favor, all right?
Okay. So, don't get hit in the face any more than you have to. Generally, that's good advice anyway, so that shouldn't be too hard to make happen. All right. I hope that Johnny Nitro turns Mick into a maximum male model. Here's the rated R superstar Edge. Still wrestling today in 2022. Despite what was once thought to be a career-ending injury.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
on the way to the ring, from Long Island, New York, Mick Foley.
Okay. All right. I mean, honestly, Foley could use a makeover. Johnny Nitro is not wrong. Not wrong at all. Okay, I wrestle Chris Benoit again. I'm so sick of wrestling Chris Benoit. This is a non-title match, so it matters even less. I want to wrestle anyone other than Chris Benoit. Okay.
Tonight, SmackDown's going to bring down the house in Salt Lake City, Utah. I'm Michael Cole here with Taz at ringside.
You got that right.
Grab the headlock on me.
Man, I am so pumped up and amped up. I can't wait.
Neither can I, Taz. And I'm sure these Salt Lake fans can either. So let's get this show on the road.
Bang, bang. Foley already feeling it.
This is one heck of a match so far.
It sure is, Taz. What do you
knife
think
edge chops. Sitting Benoit into the corner.
When you decide to shut you,
he's taking a little time to give his opponent a piece of his mind.
Okay. Okay, I'm tired from taunting so much. That's the problem with taunting.
Man, you talk about superstars who ain't got an ounce of quit in them, huh? You're looking at him right here.
The Benoit catching all my kicks. Oh, and a big chop. Momentum shifting. Benoit locks up. Got front chancery on. Oh, into a side suplex. Benoit's kind of making this work. Uh-oh. Ooh. What an interesting exchange of things that are almost like wrestling holds. Uh-oh. Benoit's kind of got going on here.
I love hearing the crowd come alive, even when I don't exactly agree with what they're saying.
Me too. And I do agree with what they're saying, Taz. The adrenaline is pumping.
Uh-oh.
This is what they came to see.
Hey, Cole, you know what? Try to restrain yourself.
Ooh, a big power bomb. Oh, no. Right down the middle. Oh, a double power bomb. Look at Foley go. I totally get that, Kevin. The extra ridiculousness of the Undertaker Kane stuff had a charm to it. There's no question.
I hope this isn't the last time we see these superstars face off.
I hope this is the very last time we see these superstars face off. TBH.
But there are certainly some issues between these superstars, and I think this match might only exasperate
them. Oh, what a maneuver.
I said exasperate.
Not, okay.
Oh, never mind.
Whoa. I think these
fans got a little something they want to share with us. Big slam.
Tickets after all. Look at this. No fear on the face of this superstar.
Yeah, that 50 cents will get you a cup of coffee.
Okay, store up my finisher.
When he took that little vacation from SmackDown, you know what I'm saying? We all know that the competition on Raw isn't exactly impressive, and I think Benoit might have.
All right. Oh! He hits the claw.
If anything, Benoit's become more impressive since he went to Raw. It's great to see him in action again tonight.
Okay, Foley really taking control here.
These superstars have been going hard all match.
They sure have. And that's where the superb conditioning of the WWE superstars comes into play.
No doubt, Cole. There ain't no way you're going to win a match if you're out of gas 2 minutes into it.
Uh-oh. Puts me in the corner.
I've seen matches won and lost.
Yeah, the Undertaker as a evil biker was an interesting turn. Then there's a little period where he's trying to be like, now I'm an MMA fighter guy. That's a little puzzling.
A lot of respect for Chris Benoit, but he also jumped back and forth.
Okay.
More than any other
superstar. There we go. Russian leg sweep. That's how we do it.
If you know what I'm saying.
Okay, let's see if we can get a little bit more of a power move going on here. Oh! What a neck breaker. Okay, we've got our... Oh, he reversed my finish. Not cool. Uh-oh. Mick Foley's so tired he can barely walk around. We're gaining some stamina.
Alright, Cole, you know what? I'm just gonna drop it. It's pretty...
This is gonna be big.
Oh, that was a mistake. Accidental.
These superstars give everything they got when they're in a match like this.
Okay. Mick, you gotta get this one put away. It's time for a big finish.
No question. If you want to make it in the WWE, you've got to sacrifice just about everything for your career. It has to be as important to you as...
You know, instead of...
Oh, he takes him out. Ready to take him for a ride.
Come on, Taz.
Whoa, look at that roll through. Uh-oh. No! Not cool, Benoit.
When you see this level of competition, Cole, there is no doubt that SmackDown's just head and shoulders better than Raw.
I couldn't agree more, Taz. Raw has some incredible superstars. No question.
Uh-oh, he spins me around. Spins me right around.
Compete with SmackDown's finest.
Come on, Cole. I know you're just trying to be diplomatic, but you can't seriously sit there and say that this...
Okay, double arm DDT. That should be enough to finish it. There we go. Wait, what happened? I got a one count. Oh, is Johnny Nitro going to run in? And we need a loading screen for that.
What's Johnny Nitro doing out here? This isn't his match.
He's watching his buddy's back, Cole, just like he said he would.
Oh, no.
My God, the speed of Chris Benoit.
There it is, Cole. Benoit's got a cross.
No.
He's tapping. He's tapping.
Benoit's not letting up, and Johnny Nitro can't get in the ring to stop it.
Oh, no, Johnny Nitro's hair is clipping through his face.
Slack, Cole. He just tried to help his buddy, and it backfired in a big way.
Oh, no. Ah, beans. Yeah, WrestleMania XXVIII is a lot. Okay, let's keep going here. I'm determined now to win this title. Okay. Not convinced it's an accident. Uh-oh. Tag team match. Oh, no. Uh-oh. These are usually where things get a little bit ugly. Ooh. Let's save. I don't think we've saved our season yet. Man, a lot of important progress. We gotta save this. Okay. Here we go. All right, memory card accessed. Week begun. And now it's time for us to do a tag team match. Benoit and Batista. Oh no. Drax the Destroyer versus Mick Foley and Johnny Nitro. That's a main event anywhere in the country. How do I tag someone is a question I might ask myself. Let's see. What is my tag button? Oh no. Tag.
I think it was pretty cool.
A button.
Nitro to team up against Benoit. Nitro is a tag team specialist and a multi-time former tag team champion. And just about the best guy you could ask to...
Okay, I can't watch all these intros again. We're gonna have to watch four people come in. And everyone is gonna get like a 7-second loading screen. Okay, I haven't seen Batista's interest yet, so we'll watch that though. You gotta see what Batista's up to. Okay, don't need to see Chris Benoit again, but I do want to see Batista. Hey, Shot Mouth Boy. Yeah, Johnny Nitro really has kept it consistent, huh? Good to see you. The animal. Okay. Oh, he slaps his knee. He's farting out some pyro. Look at that. Generic buff tattoo man. Yeah, I've always loved Batista's belly button tattoo. It's just so great, isn't it? It's just a look you don't see very often on the WrestleMan. And it's very good. Okay, I don't need to increase the attributes of my stable. Who even
Ladies
knows what that means?
Welcome to sunny San Jose, California.
You're not like how he's rubbing the back of his head.
For you tonight.
No doubt, Cole, tonight's show's completely off the hook as we do it West Coast.
God, I've wrestled Benoit so many times so today. Oops. Foley goes to the top.
To see the SmackDown superstars in action, and neither can I.
Boy, that's a lot of chops. Tattoo happy trail. There it is. That's the thing. That's the look. Oh, Benoit catches the foot. Catch these foots. Oh no, Benoit. Really a technician in the ring. Mick Foley turned heel in Chicago? Was this an indie show or what? Uh-oh. Get out of here, Benoit. Yeah, ref, tell him. He can't be in the ring. He's not the legal man. Oh, wow. You tell me more about what he did to turn heel. And when was the last time Mick Foley was a heel? Goodness gracious. That's the ultimate hill turn to y'all, Wolf. Okay. What they say. Batista bomb, says one of the signs out in the crowd. Okay. Get up there for the backbreaker. Really softening up Batista here. Okay.
It could be the king and queen on commentary.
Real funny, Taz. You know,
gotta regain some strength. Get my stamina back up. Mick Foley does have the cardio he needs. That was a great reversal. Okay. Foley really making some progress here. Uh-oh. Ooh.
Professional attitude, wouldn't you say, Nitro? Nitro's got all the potential in the world, and you, even you, actually, gotta respect that.
I respect Nitro's potential, Taz, but as far as I'm concerned, he needs some...
Okay, rest and leg sweep.
...he's entitled to an ego like that.
I gotta tell you, Cole, I thought I had this thing figured out.
Oh!
I have no idea how this is gonna end up.
Look at all this offense.
And I think it's that unpredictability that makes it so exciting.
No doubt, Cole. I've seen superstars get a huge advantage over their opponents and still lose the match.
Okay.
Because they got sloppy.
Anything can
we pull him up.
WWE.
Oh, he's got him up for the crucifix power bomb. Oh, my goodness. Razor's edge from Mick Foley. You don't expect to see that.
You never know when something huge is going to go down.
He's going for the pin.
Okay, one count.
These superstars are on top of their game.
Ooh, I have to look at this more closely. Had a weird face. She got so damn angry about stupid the WWF kept the Attitude Era. I mean, yeah, getting way into wrestling is part of the wrestling experience. We all get there eventually. And also, Shy Mouth Boy, they should have seen Mick Foley siding with Frank the Clown due to his pre-existing relationship with Yerpel the Clown. So, I mean, he has a history of working alongside clowns.
But only one of them is going to have their hand raised. That's at great, the end of this one. And he can talk all he wants, Cole, but once he's lost the match, this guy's going to wish that he spent more time going after his opponent.
Okay. Come on, game.
I think this is going to make his victory tonight that much sweeter.
I wish I knew how to tag, but I don't, so it's probably going to be Mick in the ring this whole match.
It's so great seeing these athletes compete here tonight. I had a feeling they were going to wind up against each other sooner or later.
There were times when it seemed like it wasn't going
to happen. Wow, Batista was manhandling Foley.
That's for sure. You know, any time you throw these kind of combustible elements into a match,
ooh,
you're
wow.
guaranteed to get a hell of a show.
And that's exactly
with those slow motion punches. Uh-oh.
He's tagging in his partner.
Gathering, Batista. You're not the legal man. You're really sullying what tag team wrestling is supposed to be all about. Oops, sorry, ref. Well, there you go. That could be a DQ, arguably. Bang, bang!
Getting the crowd on your side can be a huge psychological boost.
Ooh, what a maneuver.
Tough job.
Can you imagine seeing Mick Foley do a drop kick like that, pop straight back up and do another drop kick? You have to rest for 3 weeks afterwards. Okay, got him up. What's the move going to be? Oh, just a power slam. You love to see it. That's just good, clean wrestling. Oh, there we go. Okay, Foley in control. Foley, not knowing how to tag his partner, stuck in the ring this entire match. It's like a two-on-one match. Okay. Another power slam.
You know what I'm saying? We all know that the competition on Raw isn't exactly impressive, and I think Benoit might have gotten a little rusty.
What are you talking about?
Oh, big move there from Foley. Putting the hurt into Chris Benoit. Got him in a chin lock now. Batista comes in, punches the ref. A reasonable response to the events in the ring. Okay. Boy, it'd be great if Johnny Nitro came in to help me while I'm being double teamed. If only I had a partner.
So have I. It's certainly been one of the most anticipated matchups in recent
weeks. Puts me in the corner. Oh, hits me with a drop kick. Knocks me down to my butt butt. Benoit heading for the tag. Oh, Mick Foley cuts him off.
And that's an impressive thing in and of itself.
Oh, Foley with the double arm DDT. That's his finish, folks. But can he capitalize on it?
Batista has had lots of success so far.
Come on, help me out. Come on, Nitro. Did Nitro not get in the ring? For real.
This is one heck of a match so far.
Has Johnny Nitro never seen a tag team match, maybe?
That'll probably come a little bit later on in the match. When you decide to shut your yap for a few seconds, and I can enjoy it in peace.
Okay, now we got one, two... Oh, so close. So close. The tap L1 to complain to the referee. I don't know what that would do. Ooh, double drop kick. That's not good.
And that's where the superb conditioning of the WWE superstars comes into play.
No doubt, Cole.
Hey, Mick, get up. You're not dead.
2 minutes into it.
You can say that again.
Okay. We're gaining a little stamina.
Simply because one superstar was able to outlast their opponent.
Okay, that's not the tag button.
Every time I see Johnny Nitro in action, I'm blown away. Hey, let's think about it. He's still just a kid. He's got his whole career.
I have no idea how to tag.
To resist the submission hold.
And that means you got to either dig deep and find a way to break it, or you got to just
wow. Pull
it
out
and tap out.
This capacity crowd is making their opinions known tonight.
No surprise there, Cole.
All right, ref's out. Oh, well.
What's going to happen now? Any
Oh no. Uh-oh. I have no clue how to tag. I wish I had instructions for this ding dang game.
Isn't just about competition, it's also about entertaining the fans.
Okay, well, if that's the case, how come they got you as an announcer? I mean, that ain't exactly
entertainment. I'm using an Xbox controller, yes. I'm playing the PlayStation 2 version. Oh no, triple German suplex. Yeah, I couldn't get A to tag when I tried it earlier, but maybe I wasn't in the right position. Maybe I didn't have enough stamina to tag. Mick Foley looks kind of dead right now. Really raising the
bar here tonight. They sure are, Taz. We're seeing some great intensity here tonight.
And that's the name of the game, Cole. Intensity.
Nope, that rolled me out of the ring.
Your opponent until one of you looks like a tag.
Oh, I made the tag. Not the legal man. Went for the pin for some reason.
And I can't tell
okay,
you
Johnny
how
Nitro.
I am with what I've seen here tonight so far.
How could you not be impressed, Taz? These are some of the greatest superstars.
Rat Stick is calling your partner for interference. Is that a button press or a
I went into this expecting a good match. I'm just saying it's even better.
Come on, Nick.
I know exactly what you mean. These superstars certainly are pulling out all the stops.
Oh wow. Nitro with a big move.
Looks like they might be taking this
match roll outside.
The pace of the match may have slowed, but the intensity of these superstars certainly has.
Oh, sorry, Raph. You know, Mick Foley was pretty athletic for a guy who is just like a normal guy. I would say
you just can't put
impressively athletic for someone. I don't know how to get out of the ring. Russian leg sweep. Okay, it forced me out of the ring. Now I'm out of stamina.
Chris Benoit's a great technical wrestler, no doubt about it, I'm telling you. But after taking all the abuse he's taken in his career, I don't know if he's got what it takes to win here tonight.
Rap button the plus D-pad is calling for interference. Okay.
He's got a well-earned reputation for coming out ahead in just about any encounter.
Hey, look at Johnny Nitro going. Refs tell me I have to leave the ring. I don't know. I don't see why. Oh, he's doing that one move he does. Pin him. Just pin him. I'll take care of Benoit. Oh, so close. Oh no, I actually hit my partner! Oh, sorry, Morrison. I hope you don't get Batista bombed because of that.
Take your word for it, Taz. I honestly can't imagine a more electric atmosphere. Oh my, the submission hold is
okay.
And this ain't easy to get out of either, Cole.
All right, it's Benoit and Foley out on the out on the concrete.
As long as it wins matches, it's going to keep happening.
That's the bottom line, Cole. If you're not doing
Foley has it out. Ooh.
I love hearing the crowd come alive, even when I don't.
He's got it covered. One, two, three.
Aha! We won! Ah! I had Benoit neutralized outside the ring, and we got the big victory. Woo! Can't believe it. I'm going to win this ding dang title.
Nitro's going for Benoit.
Uh-oh.
Looks like Batista's not having any of that.
He's trying to tell Benoit that he wasn't in on it.
There ain't no reasoning with the rabbit Wolverine.
Oh no. Crossface chicken wing.
He's got him locked in the crossface. Two crossfaces in 2 weeks with friends like Johnny Nitro. Who needs enemies?
These storylines are pretty good. This, among a lot of wrestling fans, I think is considered to be the WWE game with the best storyline mode. And I have to say, between having voice acting and having the commentators actually like update you on what's going on, that alone makes it better than most of them. Like, this is better than story modes that you see in a lot of the games that have been just released in the last 2 or 3 years. There's no good reason for that. Okay. Christ, trying to reconsider your Q rating as champ. Okay. So I asked for a non-title triple threat match with you, me, and Benoit. Alright, triple threat match. Here we go. Have to fight Johnny Nitro, I guess. Ding dang it. Ding dang it all to heck. I don't want to fight Johnny Nitro. I don't want to fight Chris Benoit anymore. I've wrestled since we started playing this, like, oh my god, what feels like 10 matches against Chris Benoit already. There is no good reason to continue having to wrestle Chris Benoit. It is so awful. It's pretty standard for the WWE. I just don't want it to have to be Benoit. I hate that I'm locked into a story. It's hard to have, like, fun, laughy moments with Chris Benoit. All right, I'm ready to do this. Let's just get there. I'm going to take Benoit's belt at whatever the next pay-per-view is. What comes after No Mercy? Whatever it is, I'm taking his belt. I'm going to be the champion. Mrs. Foley's baby boy is bringing home the championship gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to SmackDown. Coming to you tonight from Charlotte, North Carolina.
Deep in the heart of wrestling country, Cole. This crowd is fired up, and I'll tell you what, so am I.
An enthusiastic crowd and the greatest superstars.
All right.
In sports entertainment.
Great hit.
You can't ask for more than that.
Oh, look at Foley go. Russian leg sweep.
Obvious since the beginning who you're rooting for.
I never claimed to be completely objective, Taz. It's
no, I won't get to Benoit. Russian leg sweep.
Show some sportsmanship in the ring.
Who is he, Nikita Volkov?
I'm not exactly kosher, but you're putting your body on the line in there. You gotta do whatever it takes.
And oh, what's Johnny Nitro doing? That was really the move? The world's slowest airplane spin?
Self-defense is one thing, but cheating to steal a victory and enhance your own career is something completely different.
Ooh. Won't he just leave him alone? Oh, he's going for the pin? No, I didn't think that would work. We'll complain to the ref. No, I didn't give you the option. Alright. Let's work on that chin.
He's going straight for the submission. And this could prove to be a decisive moment in this match.
Alright. Johnny Nitro locks up. Oh, he's going to crotch him on the ropes. And he's going to do the shake. There it is. Boingy, 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 boingy. Boy, that does not look like Benoit is selling it at all. Benoit, no selling the crotching.
No doubt. I don't care how tough you are. That hurts.
That reversal might stop his opponent's momentum dead. What a cowardly move. He can't win fair and square, so he tries to screw his opponent out of the victory.
Hey, look, there's nothing wrong with him doing whatever it takes to win the match. If it was that bad,
oh, schoolboy roll up.
Thank you, Captain.
Nope. Not today. I want this win.
Rather than compete fairly.
Russian leg sweep. Since when does Foley do this 3 or 4 times in one match?
I gotta tell you, Cole, I thought I had this thing figured out, but now I got no idea how this is gonna happen.
Okay. Foley working the arm.
It's so exciting.
No doubt, Cole. I've seen superstars get a huge advantage over their opponents and still lose the match.
Okay, Foley loads up a finish. What's he doing? He's hitting the wrong button is what he's doing.
Every time I see Johnny Nitro in action, I'm blown away. And let's think about it. He's still just a kid.
He's got his whole career ahead of him.
Okay. Here we go. Making things happen. No! You know it's not going to work, man. Come on. Come on. Uh-oh. Oh, look at that maneuver.
This has been a great match so far.
Oh, and right in the center of the ring, Foley goes for the mandible claw, which for some reason this game is not a submission hold. It's simply a takedown. It's inexplicable, given the history of this move, that it's not used as a submission here. Uh-oh. Foley taking him up. Oh, crucifix powerbomb! What a maneuver.
Man,
this,
I'll tell you what,
okay.
He wasted no time going for that pin.
Ooh, it's close. It's close. Almost had it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are seeing an incredible display of athletic ability.
Get a little stamina back while Johnny Nitro works on Benoit.
WWE superstar for crying out loud.
Hey, we're supposed to be friends. You're helping with my Q rating. Welcome in, everybody, by the way, if you're just joining us. So glad you could be here for some SmackDown vs. Raw 2007. Decaf Jetta. Like to play retro games. Playing Day of the Tentacle tonight. A classic point-and-click adventure at 9:30 p.m. Eastern. Can't wait for that one. But for now, we're going to double arm DDT Chris Benoit. And then we're going to break up this pin attempt. Because that's not fair. I did the move. You shouldn't get the pin. Then we're going to try to make a pin.
He's going for the pin. Kicked out.
What? Complain to the ref. Oh no! While I was complaining, Johnny Nitro grabbed me. Ooh!
I don't believe it.
A punch to the dongular region.
It's so great seeing these athletes. You know, there is
okay. Foley takes him out. Oh, exactly, crucifix powerbomb! Oh, where does Foley find the power? He goes for the big cover.
One, two, three.
Woo, we won a triple threat match! This is great. Okay, folks, now we've got it rolling. Triple threat matches are not my
You can say that again, and it's going to come to a head this Sunday. Whoa, whoa, wait a minute. What's Nitro doing? Johnny Nitro's got the title belt. Here comes Cole. I told you Nitro.
Oh!
Nitro hit Chris Benoit. Nitro hit the champion. I don't believe it. I told you, Cole.
Foley putting on the cross-faced chicken wing.
Nitro actually was trying to help the contender all along. It was Chris Benoit he was trying to sabotage all this
time. Wow. Ooh, man. Did you see that? Oh, this is building up some heat for the PPV. We're going to pop a buy rate. Yeah. Okay, what's our latest text message?
Hey, champ. We sure showed Chris Benoit who's boss last Friday night on SmackDown, huh? If you do that at Survivor Series, you're the new World Heavyweight Champion. I wish I could be there to watch your back, but for some reason, Teddy Long says he's banning me from the arena. Anyway, give me a call back so we can discuss some strategy, okay? I've got a great plan that'll make the last few weeks look like child's play.
Oh, later. No. Is this going to stop me from getting the title? Is Johnny Nitro going to ruin my title shot?
Hey, dude, it's Nitro again. I haven't heard back from you, so maybe you didn't get the last message or something. Listen, you've got to call me back so we can discuss your title match. I've put way too much time and energy into this thing for it to fall apart now. Plus, I've got three magazines fighting for the exclusive cover story about your championship. I'll have my cell phone on all day, except for my 5 o'clock teeth whitening treatment, of course. Hey, You know, you should really consider that. I know this guy who... Well, anyway, give me a call. We'll do lunch.
All right. Teeth whitening's pretty good. Oh, wow.
Hey, Mr. Big Shot. I don't know what your problem is, but I left you two...
Now, this is a story mode. Back.
Maybe now that you put Chris Benoit on the crossface, you think you're too good to talk to... Hold on a sec. Oh, hey there, Chris. What's up, champ? Wait, hold on, Benoit. No, don't...
Too bad you couldn't see your little pal here tap out just now. But I'll be seeing you tap tonight.
Wow. What a twist. You know, John Morrison, Johnny Nitro, was a contestant a few seasons ago on Survivor. Speaking of Survivor Series. And he was pretty good there. He was really, really a lot of fun out on the island. It's a season worth checking out. Came across pretty charming for the most part. All right. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, so it's a submission match. There's no pin, I take it? Okay. That's not going to be good for Mick Foley. We're in a submission match for the title. Just a regular contestant. A lot of the people didn't know that he was a wrestler, in fact. I think he kind of kept that to himself, at least initially. Just regular old Survivor. Ultimate submission match. That's even more submission-y. Okay. I hope that Johnny Nitro doesn't interfere here. I'm Johnny Island. Johnny Survivor. I'm Johnny Survivor, Mayor of Slamtown. Nice to meet you. I'm a carpenter. God, how did he not call himself Johnny Survivor while he was there? He was just John. That's no good. Oh, that was such a missed opportunity. What's Johnny Survivor doing in the Impact Zone? Okay, so I have to win this by submission, which is going to be difficult. Since for some reason the Mandible Claw is not a submission hold in this game, once again, makes no sense whatsoever. Oh wait, it's a 20-minute time limit, and we have to see who gets the most submissions? That's a weird match. Is that a... thing that WWF does occasionally? Superstars compete against each other here tonight, JR. I had a feeling their paths were going to cross. Ooh, a float over DDT.
Me too.
You hate to see it.
To sit next to you and listen to those corny expressions of yours. What the heck is a government mule anyway? It's what you get beat like. We're in the middle of...
Oh, we got good old JR on commentary this episode.
You don't have the guts to stick around. You might run like a scalded dog with a case of the limber tape.
All right. Enough. We're locked in this indefinitely. Wow. Benoit is just wrecking me. Just absolute wrecking. He's a wrecking machine. No, he's got me in submission. Oh no, there's a mini game. I'll never do it. Oh, it's terrible. I think I just submitted. Or did I not? Oh, what a terrible mechanic. Oh no. Come on, escape. Oh, wow, I can't do anything against Benoit.
It sure is, King, and even if you break the hold, it takes its toll on you.
Russian leg sweep. Yeah, I've never heard of a match like this either. I mean, I know Iron Man matches that usually go like 60 minutes, and it's how many pinfalls you get in 60 minutes. I guess this is just the submission version of that. Oh man, Benoit has his finish. He's going to tap me out right here with the crossface. Intelligence of these WWE fans. Well, I heard that we gave him an IQ test and the results came back negative.
Looks like I got to apologize to the king here tonight. Now, he must have gotten up on the wrong side of somebody else's bed.
Okay, Foley. Okay, now we've got one locked in. What are you going to do, Benoit, with the neck wrench?
I'm so disgusted.
One of the most deadly moves in all of wrestling.
He could have stayed with Triple okay. H and McFlair in Evolution and continued to ride the coattails of two of the greatest legends.
Big power slam. Shades the British Bulldog.
What are you talking about, King? Batista never wrote anyone's coattails. He's his own man.
Okay, locking a submission.
And he's got his opponent locked in a submission hold. We can see a tap out right here.
Which one's square and which one's circle? Square is okay, yeah.
Boy, what a match. I wouldn't even have
oh,
to
no.
guess.
Oh no. Oh no.
What? Have you got both your contacts in one eye?
The dongular region of Foley under assault.
The start of the match. Oh really? Well then, why don't you just enlighten the rest of us, King? No way. I can already tell this is going to be a great match. Oh, no.
All right. Foley takes him up. And crucifix powerbomb.
Oh, no. This is terrible. You can't let your opponent build this kind of momentum. Well, all I can say is...
Ooh, and a big chop. Big knife edge chop. Oh, Benoit turns the tables.
You can fool some of the people all of the time. And all the people some of the time.
Uh-oh. Benoit, ooh, with a snap suplex. Pulls Foley to the middle of the ring. Foley gets up.
Sometimes I get exhausted just watching these superstars compete. I know what you mean, Jay.
Okay. Foley trying to lock on some kind of leg submission. Unlikely to work. Okay, rope break. This is going to be a thrilling 1-0 finish, I predict. Uh-oh, Benoit, the reversal. Benoit works the arm. Mick Foley, quick takedown. Bang, bang!
Here we go. What a jerk.
What a jerk. They need to get tired himself out by bang, banging.
Decided to exercise the right of free speech. God bless the First Amendment, JR.
You know, you have two sets of commentators in this game for SmackDown and Raw, and both of them have multiple references to, like, oh, that's just the crowd expressing their First Amendment rights when they're booing something or, you know, cheering a dastardly move, which makes me think there had to be something going on in the WWE at the time where, like, probably Vince McMahon had been criticized or the company had been criticized, and they must have been instructing people to talk about the First Amendment a lot. I would love to know why that appears so frequently in this game.
Show off all you want, but it's not going to win you the match.
It's not a knowing the WWE, that's not a coincidence. They keep talking about the First Amendment and fans having the right to express it and all that sort of stuff.
Force of nature? More like...
Okay, go tap him out with this chin lock. Nope.
I can't even imagine the pain being inflicted here.
Uh-oh, here comes the mandible claw.
I think I know who's going to win this one, JR. Oh, real. Enlightenment.
Again, not a submission for some reason.
I'm eager to hear my prediction because I want to know who's going to win.
Okay. Work it. Okay. We can tap him to this. Come on.
Absolutely right, King.
No.
We've seen many superstars tap out for this.
I'm out of energy. I am a dead man walking. Not to be confused with the actual dead man walking back in the locker room.
Commitment and the dedication of these superstars to their career.
Okay. Big backdrop.
Every superstar on the roster.
Okay, lock in that submission, Mick. You got him right in the center of the ring. Work those legs. Well, I don't have much going on in the legs yet. I need to work his head. That's where my good stuff is.
Oh,
Benoit reverses.
Signed up for, King, and quite frankly, I think these fans would be disappointed if they didn't go all
okay.
Out.
Foley the with the mandible claw,
never set foot inside that ring.
Working on the neck of Benoit.
To watch what goes on
goes on inside and without them, we're all be out of the job.
Oh boy, these fans have got something on their minds, JR.
Well, they paid for their tickets, King, and they've got a right.
Boy, I really want to win this WWE Championship. I have a lot emotionally invested in this idea now.
Well,
okay, get him in the submission. Pull him out of the ropes. Get him out of the ropes.
I think this is still an extreme.
What a submission hold! Could this be a tap out?
It isn't. The hold can't be broken. You can't take this kind of pain for long.
Okay, still no submissions. Double arm DDT on Benoit. Ooh.
Can you imagine SmackDown putting on a match half as good as this?
No disrespect intended.
Okay. Oh, Benoit reversing out of it. There'll be no finisher there.
And you hit the nail right on the head there, JR. The dominant.
Okay. Get him down. Get him, Nick. Work the legs. Work the legs.
Absolutely not.
Tap, 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 tap. Tap, 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 tap.
Force his opponent to tap out right here.
I think these superstars.
Yeah, exactly. They pay for their tickets. They have the right to say whatever they want to. The most important part of being a wrestling fan. Look at Sloth Mick just walking around, bent over.
Is that why you always seem to be in such a hurry?
Oh man, Mick Foley about to die.
My day, King, to hurry anywhere.
Okay.
I think I know who's.
Look at him feeding off the energy.
Okay.
Capacity crowd.
Pull him up.
He's unstoppable.
And here's the crucifix. Razor's edge.
And they'll abandon you in a heartbeat.
They do a little punchy punchy on the face. And then a little submitty on the leg.
It really drives home the fact that Raw is the dominant brand of sports entertainment.
Oh, there's
Come on, Raph, that's not a rope break.
It sure isn't, JR. I've been on the wrong end of that one many times.
Yeah, I've got to know why this game is all about everyone expressing their their First Amendment rights. Like I said, there had to be some sort of criticism in the news at the time.
So, JR,
and the official company line is, we're going to frame this as a free speech question. Okay, let's get our submission on. Oh, Boston Crab. Why did we roll him so far over?
These superstars are putting on a great match so far, JR. But if they drop the ball, these fans will let them hear about it.
I don't think that's going to happen, King. These competitors know that their paychecks come straight from the
Okay,
WWE.
We've injured every part of Benoit's body. We should be able, here in a moment, to put him away with at least one submission. Let's go. Come on, gang. Here it comes. Here it comes. Here's the first submission of the Ultimate Submission Pack. We're going to tap away. Oh, he's got so much strength still. How's this work? Oh, man. Gain some stamina. Do it again. We're just going to keep it up. Bad news, Benoit.
Look what's going on in the ring.
Okay, I got him this time. Ah, I can't tap fast enough. All right. Okay, there's one submission on the record. Took us 10 minutes or so, but we got one.
So how do you think this one's going to turn out, JR?
Honestly, King, I have absolutely no idea.
Oh, Foley's got him up. Oh, he's taking him for a ride.
But I'd rather keep it to myself if it's all the same to you, King.
He gently sits him down. What a stupid move.
Do you believe we actually get paid to do this job, JR?
It's a dream come true, King.
Okay.
To sit here and listen to you drool over the defense.
Okay, let's see if we get another submission out of him. Come on, get him out of the ropes, Mick.
And that's why I'm bringing the
You have an option to ignore the rope break.
He sure is. There's no doubt he's looking for the submission right here. I think this crowd's giving these superstars a piece of their minds, King.
Boy, Benoit's got no offense this match. Hey, bang!
And now he's
Mick's feeling it.
Piece of his mind.
He's going to have to eat those words by the end of this match, JR.
And backbreaker.
I think we're going to find out just how much punishment the human body can withstand here tonight.
I think you're right, King. These superstars seem intent on taking each other to the
okay.
I love that attitude, JR. Go big or go home.
Well, these superstars sure aren't going home until this match is
set. All right, locking in.
For all.
Some sort of maneuver.
Boy, it's obvious these
oh, Benoit showing some signs of life with an arm drag.
And this is one hell of an exam.
Let's hope it's not their final exam, JR. I'd love to see them go at it again.
Well, if I think the fans have their way, you'll get your wish, King.
Okay, round the center of the ring. We're gonna lock it in. Oh, Benoit reversing. Oh, what a back and forth match. This is what the WWE Universe pays for.
I think it's pretty obvious which way this one's gonna go, JR.
Well, from my perspective, this is still anybody's match.
Okay. Drop. Pull him up here. Oh, give him the chin lock. No chance. I'm gonna tap you straight out to tap out town. No.
You can look at any professional sport you want, JR, and you won't find more incredible athletes.
Oh, Benoit reversing out of this again. He won't let me go for the submission. Which seems very selfish.
Physically incapable of
what does he think he's doing? He's just showing up for the crowd now. He's wrestling the match.
Oh, fireman's carry takeover. Okay, let's get back some stamina. Oh, this would be a horrible match, IRL. Like, fans are not going to love this. Oh, no. Mick's doing his thing. Boom. Oh, some sweatpants to the back of Chris Benoit. Okay, double arm DDT. The Woeverse, yes.
This isn't ballet, you know. Well, really, JR. Gosh, tell me more about your in-ring experience.
Oh, no.
I've got a pinfall victory over Triple H to my credit. How about you?
Okay, I've reversed it. Oh, he reverses my reversal. Oh, but I've reversed his reversal of my reversal. Oh, no, but he comes out on top. Benoit, too injured to stand.
They've lost the match.
Uh-oh. He whipped me into the corner.
You can't ever let your opponent know the extent of your injury.
And that's easier said than done, JR. The human body can only absorb so much punishment. Listen to the crowd, JR. I think they've got something to say to these two.
Oh, no. Benoit with the reversals. We pulled him off the map.
Remember, without these fans, these superstars are out of it.
Okay, I gotta get some stamina back. Boy, a 20-minute submission match with one submission is gonna be really something to behold.
I can't believe it's finally underway.
Okay, we'll do our sweatpants smash again.
And as far as I'm concerned, it's living up to the
no question about that, JR. The fans certainly seem to be
another double arm DDT.
And when it comes down to it,
is that game close enough to the center of the ring to get a submission locked in? Who's to say? Okay, here we go. Oh yeah. Yeah, it's still so hard even when you've got beaten to death. Oh, he kicks out of it. My lord. A backbreaker. Regain. Mick Foley can't stand up. He's so tired. Gotta regain that stamina. Gotta get it back. We are in the red zone. He goes too far into there. He literally just dies in the ring. Okay.
The WWE fans agree with me as often as they do.
Big backdrop.
How much more of this I can stand to listen to, JR? You know what the difference between you and I-95 is? You can turn off I-95.
Okay, come on.
JR's not going to be happy about this one, folks. I think one of his favorites is going to get beat like the proverbial...
Okay, here we go. Let's try it again. Come on, Mick. Oh, my goodness. Oh, there it is. All right. A little bit of breathing room. Got two submissions now. and only 3 minutes to go. This has got to be a win. I'm going to get the title here, folks. Unless my idiot son, Johnny Nitro, runs in and breaks this up.
This has all the makings of an instant classic.
Ooh, that's Benoit with a flurry of offense.
Well, I did have some good old work on the barbecue before the night showed. I don't think that's it.
I love that after every move, Mick Foley is now completely exhausted. Yeah, you know, I think that the focus on heavyweights traditionally in the industry means that they tend to get the most opportunities for character development, you know, the main event storylines. But yeah, back in the old days of WCW, I was all about their luchadors. Like, that was what I tuned in for in a lot of ways. Watching Rey Mysterio and Eddie Guerrero just have five-star classics every week. Wow. They follow just punishing Chris Benoit.
You sure don't. You've got to lay the groundwork first.
Chris Benoit's entire body in pain, according to the diagram we see.
Let me tell you, JR, you won't see action like this anywhere except on Raw. That's for sure,
oh.
King. There's not
punch the solar plexus.
Entertainment out there that can compare with this capacity.
Okay, Foley's taking him out.
Behind their superstar. Look at this.
And here comes, oh, the razor's edge. Foley has to get his breath.
Man, is there even going to be anything left of these?
Yeah, I mean, Rey Mysterio was fantastic. He still is. He's still going. Which, considering what a high-impact style he wrestles, it is remarkable to me that he is still in the business. I can't believe his knees haven't just exploded out of his body yet.
This has gone beyond just being a match, JR. I think these superstars genuinely hate each other. There's
okay.
No flaws between these competitors, that's for sure. If looks could kill,
okay, so we've made it to a minute 20 left. We're going to win this match. Mick Foley's going to get the title. That'll probably be the end of my stream this morning, but tonight I will be back with Day of the Tentacle at 9:30 p.m. Eastern. I can't wait for that. Please be sure to join me for Retro Adventure Wednesday. We are going to have a blast. But first things first, I've got to win this title. Thank you, Bogey. Okay. Uh-oh. I've got him in some sort of submission. I didn't mean to put on, but I think he's going to get... Ooh, 3-0 with 30 seconds to go. There's bad news for you, Benoit. Your title is about to be my title. Bang, bang!
Everyone knows that overconfidence costs superstars matches. That might be true, King.
Bang, bang!
Superstar who's got
20 minute Mick versus Chris match. Yeah, it's the great best way to go. Oh wow, Chris Benoit has been down the mat for like 40 seconds. That's a rough way to end it. While your opponent's taunting, you can't answer the ref's call. Oh wow, oof. Oh man, poor Chris Benoit. Yes.
He did it. He did it. He beat the champion, Chris Benoit, his own game. I never would have thought it after what we've
been
through a few weeks, but we have a new world heavyweight champion here at Survivor Series. And let's give Jeff Rick breakfast, too. Don't forget, the champ's got Johnny Nitro to thank. If anything, you should probably thank our...
I don't have Johnny Nitro to thank. I have my excellent submission skills to thank. Ah, that's great. I won the belt. Yeah. Woo. We did it. I can't believe it. Oh, my goodness. Oh, we've unlocked the Heart Foundation package, you say? Tell me more. Tell me more. Does that mean I can buy Bret Hart? Oh, can I buy Bret Hart? If I can unlock Bret Hart now. That's going to be pretty sweet. I really want to unlock Bret Hart. Let's see. Shop. Ooh, I can. I can unlock Bret and Jim the Anvil, not Hart. Thanks to Johnny Survivor. I'm definitely unlocking Bret Hart. I mean, yes. I will consider whether I would unlock Jim Neidhart. I mean, I'm not as interested in that one. All right. Okay, so we did it. I wonder if we got cutscene coming up here. I guess not. It'll probably just take us back to the... Oh, there's something new in the WWF magazine. Is that what it's telling me? We better check that out. We don't want to miss whatever's going on in the magazine. Oh, star power. What? Nitro blasts Mick Foley's ingratitude. Oh, so it's setting up our next storyline against Johnny Nitro. I mean, honestly, this consistency of storytelling is better than the actual WWE has had at various times. Remembering that superstars have feuds with each other and stuff like that is something they're not always good at. So let's save our game. I may come back and play more of this. I'm having fun with the story mode. But for now, I think it's about time to wrap things up. So thanks for watching along this morning. It's always fun. You know, I never know when I do these weird daytime streams and stuff if people are going to make it in. So I appreciate y'all hanging out and chatting with me and watching along as I indulge myself in my strange addiction to wrestling video games. Before we go, again, I'm going to be back tonight. But I've said that like 8 or 9 times. Y'all know that by now. I'll be back around 9:30 p.m. Eastern to do a little bit of Day of the Tentacle. Can't wait. And then, let's see, to where shall we go? Where shall we raid? Piece of Hannah is going online right now. It looks like their stream is just starting. Oops. And they're going to be playing Heroine's Quest, which is a really fun Heroes Quest fan game that I think y'all will love if you've never seen it before. So I'm going to raid us over there. Hey, Sheldorn. Glad you could be here just for the end. Let's raid over to Pieces or Piece of Hannah. Be sure to tell her Decaf Jedi sent you. And I hope to see all y'all again tonight. Take care, everybody. And we'll see you real soon.